with the big story here. I'm Seher Zamain. We're making a start, keeping the focus in the build-up to the Delhi Assembly elections 4 days away. Today, the Aam Aadmi Party has released its manifesto. They're calling it the Dream Manifesto with 28 initiatives. This manifesto promises that the Delhi government will push for full statehood. Once again, this is an old promise that was made earlier as well, has been included in this manifesto too. 24/7 markets in Delhi. Introduce Desh Bhakti curriculum in schools. As a follow-up to what they say has been the success of the happiness curriculum that they introduced earlier in the government. They have even promised to make Bhojpuri the official language. All of this in much more that was spoken by AAP at the release of their manifesto. Let's take a listen.
ये मैनिफेस्टो एक सपना है जैसा मैंने कहा इस मैनिफेस्टो को दिल्ली इस मैनिफेस्टो में लिखे सपनों की दिल्ली बनाने को हम दो हिस्सों में बांट सकते हैं दो रोड मैप इसके रोड मैप को दो हिस्सों में बांट सकते हैं पहला माननीय मुख्यमंत्री जी की ओर से जारी किया गया एक गारंटी कार्ड जिसमें केजरीवाल की 10 गारंटी आज दिल्ली उन सब के बारे में बात कर रही है वो भी इस मैनिफेस्टो का हिस्सा है और दूसरा कुछ विस्तृत कामों की सूची है
Let's get in further inputs. We have with us our correspondent Ayushman with those details to further scrutinize and what has been mentioned. This is a dream manifesto. So the Aam Aadmi Party once again coming in with a big bang promise of creating a dream city in Delhi with all of these 28 initiatives that they would bring in if brought back to power. Ayushman, the big takeaways, of course, not all 28 necessarily manageable by the Delhi government. A lot of them fall under the domain of the central government here. But the big takeaway in what AAP has promised today.
Well, sir, if you see the manifesto of Aam Aadmi Party, the first 2 points talk about the Lokpal and the Swaraj, which the Aam Aadmi Party talked when they were not there in power, in fact, the party was not formed. So first 2 points are about that. The third point that comes is the doorstep delivery of the ration, which Manish Sisodia talked about. Then they talk about the Desh Bhakti curriculum, in which they are saying that the students would be taught the lessons of nationalism about their fundamental rights and also about the fundamental duties. Important aspect is when they talk about the Safai Karmcharis, the one whom we hear daily on a very serious note in the national capital, people die in these years. They are saying that they'll be implementing the 2011 census here. And if someone dies on duty, 1 crore compensation would be given by the government of Delhi. They've also talked about 24/7 market in the national capital. They've talked about 500 kilometers of metro connectivity. Okay. In the national capital, also about the world-class roads. Initially, it was a 10-point guarantee card, Seher, and now it has come a detailed manifesto. That is the big takeaway from the manifesto launch of Aam Aadmi Party.
Yes, Ayushman, stay on with us because we're taking a listen into some of these announcements that have been made both by Delhi Chief Minister Kejriwal, Deputy Chief Minister Sisodia as well. Delhi Chief Minister throwing up a challenge just a short while back, throwing up a challenge at the BJP, taking a jibe at the BJP for not having declared a chief ministerial face yet. In fact, Kejriwal has dared the BJP, given them a deadline of 24 hours to give out that name by 1 p.m. tomorrow.
मैं आज बीजेपी से कहना चाहता हूं कि दिल्ली के लोग ये चाहते हैं कि बीजेपी अपना सीएम कैंडिडेट डिक्लेयर करे और उस सीएम कैंडिडेट के साथ मैं बहस करने के लिए तैयार हूं अमित शाह जी ये कह रहे हैं भाई तुम हमको वोट दे दो फिर सीएम मैं तय करूंगा जनतंत्र में सीएम जनता तय करती है जनतंत्र में सीएम अमित शाह जी तय नहीं कर सकते जनता को यह अधिकार होना चाहिए तय करने का कि वो सीएम डिसाइड करे कि ये सीएम पसंद है कि ये सीएम पसंद है
Right, this is a jibe at the BJP, but Ayushman, understandably so. Despite there being a Delhi BJP chief, Manoj Tiwari, who's of course having fronted several aspects of the campaign of the elections in Delhi, and yet there is no chief ministerial candidate. It is on the leadership of Prime Minister Modi here that the BJP has decided to fight the Delhi State Assembly elections as well.
And that is why you see this timely reaction from Arvind Kejriwal, where he announces in his, like last time he said that he want to have a public debate. He is making it kind of presidential elections where he wants somebody to be in front of him and he will go on to debate. He also said that two anchors can be appointed and then we can have a debate where the questions from people can be taken. The BJP has made it clear that they are fighting this elections on the personality and the name and the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and that is why if you see there has been no declaration of the CM candidate, though there has been the name of Manoj Tiwari and several others from the BJP, but no clarity both from Congress as well as the BJP, and that has been definitely a key advantage that has worked for Arvind Kejriwal. If you see, Arvind Kejriwal mm-hmm. has been going there in the campaigning and has been saying that he is the one, but as a CM candidate, but who is from the other side? In fact, in today, the social media, right. The Aam Aadmi Party was using the hashtag Kejriwal versus Kaun. So that has been a pitch that Aam Aadmi Party has now resorted to, where they are asking as to who will be the CM candidate from BJP and Congress.
Absolutely. Ayushman, appreciate you getting us those details here. In fact, our correspondent Ayushman having taken in a response from the AAP MP Sanjay Singh as well, saying that their party is banking on all the work that they've done in the last 5 years, reiterating here that their demand that the BJP reveal their chief ministerial face.
More than 1,000 MLAs are in the national capital, along with 11 chief ministers and 300 MPs. The BJP is out for a massive outreach program in the national capital. We have Sanjay Singh with us to talk on this, sir. The kind of battery of leadership that the BJP has deployed in the national capital, how is Aam Aadmi Party dealing with that?
So, 15 ka chunav aap shayad bhool gaye. Aise hi kiya tha in logon ne. पूरी की पूरी भारतीय जनता पार्टी लगा दी थी, 300 सांसद लगा दिए थे, सारे कैबिनेट मंत्री लगा दिए थे, सब कुछ इन्होंने किया था. और क्या हुआ था, एक मंत्री ने इनके कहा राम जादे, आगे के शब्द में बोल नहीं सकता, जनता ने 67 सीटें दे दी. जितना भाजपा ताकत लगाएगी उतना दिल्ली की जनता और मजबूती से बीजेपी को जवाब देगी. ऑल वर्सेस अरविंद केजरीवाल, ये चुनाव है. आप देखिएगा परिणाम.
प्रधानमंत्री के काउंटर को कैसे कहेंगे आप?
देखिए, मैं ये कह रहा हूँ कि बीजेपी का अपना प्रचार कैंपेन का तरीका है, वो करते रहें. हमारा पॉजिटिव कैंपेन है, जनता के लिए हमने 5 साल में क्या किया है वो हम बता रहे हैं. बीजेपी के पास कुछ है ही नहीं है कि वो उन्होंने क्या किया है, तो इसलिए वो नफरत फैलाने का काम कर रहे हैं, तमाम अनाप शनाप बयान दे रहे हैं. हमारे पास बहुत कुछ है 5 साल में काम किया हुआ जो बताने लायक है. वो 13 साल MCD में क्या किया उन्होंने वो गिना नहीं सकते, क्योंकि दिल्ली को कूड़ा घर बनाने का काम उन्होंने किया, क्योंकि भ्रष्टाचार MCD में किया, तो इसलिए उनके पास कुछ नहीं है बताने को.
And these elections to happen in the midst of massive protests against the CAA that have continued across Delhi, the biggest and the longest so far being the Shaheen Bagh protest. The protesters there say that these protests will continue. They have directly, in fact, reacted to Prime Minister Modi's remarks that came in on Shaheen Bagh. Their demand that the government revoke CAA still stands. Just yesterday, Prime Minister Modi breaking his silence on Shaheen Bagh, speaking at his first Delhi election rally, saying that these protests were politically motivated.
आप लोग कब तक यहाँ पर बैठे रहेंगे? प्रधानमंत्री से
बैठे रहेंगे जब तक हमारे प्रधानमंत्री हम लोग को ना इत्मीनान दिला दे. हम लोग बैठेंगे बैठेंगे बैठे रहेंगे.
इत्मीनान कैसे दिलाना होगा उनका, क्या क्योंकि वो तो डायलॉग ही नहीं करना चाहते, वो बात नहीं करना चाहते.
करना पड़ेगा ना, जनता से सरकार है, सरकार अपने आप से नहीं है, पहले जनता फिर सरकार. हम दिए कुर्सी, कुर्सी से हम ही उतारेंगे. क्या हमारी बच्ची कहती है कि अमित शाह अंकल और मोदी अंकल से मुझे मिलना है, और मुझे मिलके आप बताना है कि सारी माए जो रोड पे आ गई, सबकी सब बच्चे की अम्मी छूट गई. वो अम्मी नहीं छूटना चाहिए, अम्मी बहुत बड़ी नेमत होती है, वो छूट गई बच्चों को, तो ये हमारे सरकार नहीं समझेगा तो कौन समझेगा?
अरे भाई, क्या ये प्रदर्शन सिर्फ एक संयोग है? जी नहीं, ये संयोग नहीं, ये एक प्रयोग है। अलग अलग केसों में अदालतों की, हमारे देश की सर्वोच्च अदालत की भावना यही रही है कि विरोध प्रदर्शनों से सामान्य मानवी को दिक्कत न हो।
Strong reactions that have come in from the opposition here on this. This includes AAP, the Congress, the TMC, having slammed the BJP for this nature of hate speeches in the build-up to the elections.
जो लोग शाहीन बाग में बैठे हुए हैं और रास्ता रुका हुआ है, उसका चुनावी फायदा कौन उठाना चाह रहा है? जाहिर सी बात है, बीजेपी पूरी की पूरी कैंपेन ही बीजेपी की शाहीन बाग के ऊपर है। तो ये शाहीन बाग का मुद्दा तो बीजेपी ने बना रखा है, वरना आप बैठिए मैं बैठ जाऊं, अगर सड़क पे हमें एक दिन भी बैठने देंगे? ऐसी हो सकता है कि कोई आदमी हाईवे रोक सके? ये तो हाईवे रोका गया है, और इससे ये कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि चुनावी फायदा हो, मगर लोग इससे समझ रहे हैं इससे इनको नुकसान होगा।
आप जब भड़काऊ काम करते हैं, आप जब कंस्पिरेसीज करते हैं, तो वो देश के लिए ठीक है, और जो बाकी लोग पीसफुल प्रोटेस्ट करते हैं वो षड्यंत्र हो गया।
जामिया या शाहीन बाग पे जो प्रोटेस्ट हो रहे हैं, वो सरकार के मुल्क को बांटने की कोशिशों के ख़िलाफ़ हो रहे हैं, और हमारे मोदी जी बिल्कुल उसके बरक्स ये कह रहे हैं कि ये शाहीन बाग की जो एक साजिश है मुल्क को बांटने की, मैं समझता हूँ कि बिल्कुल उलट उसका सही है, सच है, और जो हमारे प्रधानमंत्री जी फरमा रहे हैं वो बिल्कुल ही सच्चाई से दूर है।
इट इज़ ओनली द पॉलिटिकल स्पीच, द हेटेड स्पीच एंड द वैंडलिज्म इज गोइंग ऑन, अदरवाइज हाउ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल पोस्ट होल्डर्स आर सेइंग लाइक दिस।
Politics being played out as far as the Nirbhaya issue is concerned. Today, the Aam Aadmi Party MP Sanjay Singh raising that issue of the delay in the execution of Nirbhaya convicts. This issue was raised in the Rajya Sabha. AAP MP pushed to expedite the death sentence of the four convicts, which has currently been stayed by a lower court. But Union Minister Prakash Jawarkar then launched a scathing attack against AAP, saying that the jail authorities have delayed these proceedings, effectively blaming the Delhi government for this delay because Tihar jail reports to the state. The vice president then had to intervene, stop the heated discussion, saying there should be no politics on this issue.
के मामले में इतना विलंब होना न्याय का, फास्ट ट्रैक कोर्ट बनाई गई, सजा भी हो गई मान्यवर, लेकिन सजा होने के बाद तारीख पे तारीख लग रही है मान्यवर, जो इसमें रखा जा रहा है, बयानबाजी भी कराई जा रही है, ये बयानबाजियां हो रही हैं, राजनीतिक नेताओं की बयानबाजियां हो रही हैं, ये अत्यंत दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण है। मैं आपसे अनुरोध करता हूं हाथ जोड़कर, इसमें चाहे महामहिम राष्ट्रपति का हस्तक्षेप हो, चाहे सुप्रीम कोर्ट के मुख्य न्यायाधीश का हस्तक्षेप हो, निर्भया के अपराधियों को जल्द से जल्द फांसी दी जाए, उनको बचे रहने का कोई अधिकार नहीं होना चाहिए। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
इफ थिंग्स आर गेटिंग पोस्टपोन्ड, पीपल आर बिकमिंग रेस्क्यू, this has to be understood by one and all concerned must see to it that the judgment is implemented at the earliest.
May July 17 mein supreme court ne appeal kharij kiya, lekin jail authority ne sawa saal un gunahgaron ko jo process
vivad ka vishay
chahiye nahi bataya,
vivad ka vishay nahi banna chahiye,
this should not, ye rajya sarkar ke haath mein aata hai aur rajya sarkar ke karan ye delay hua hai.
No politics, no discussion.
As the coronavirus scare that continues in certain parts of the country, Kerala, the state of Kerala, has now declared it a state disaster. Several other states remain on high alert. Travelers from China that returned to India who are being screened. The Rajya Sabha also discussed this issue, the outbreak of coronavirus and all this that comes in with the death toll to this virus that has now touched 425 in China. Yes, we'll get you those details in just a bit, but we're going back to live inputs coming in from the Rajya Sabha, the CAA, which is now being discussed.
We followed in compulsory registration of citizen of India shall be such as may be prescribed. तो जो आप हमको कह रहे हैं ये तो समिति की रिकमेंडेशन आपने दी थी और उसके बाद इतना नहीं किया. कांग्रेस की एक स्थिति रही है कि आपको ये लगता है कि सत्ता में आप है तो सब ठीक है, सत्ता में आप नहीं है तो सब खराब हो रहा है. उसके बाद सिटीजनशिप अमेंडमेंट एक्ट में अमेंडमेंट आया और ये अमेंडमेंट में क्या सेक्शन 14 है जो कमेटी ने कहा, तो अमेंडमेंट में क्या आया, इश्यू ऑफ नेशनल आइडेंटिटी कार्ड. द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट में कंपल्सरी रजिस्टर एवरी सिटीजन ऑफ इंडिया एंड इशू नेशनल आइडेंटिटी कार्ड टू हिम. और ये कब आया, ये इंसर्ट कब हुआ, ये इंसर्ट हुआ 3 दिसंबर 2004 को. और मनमोहन सिंह जी प्रधानमंत्री कब बने, 22 मई 2004 को. अब बताइए उपसभापति महोदय, आखिर हम देश में भरमाने की राजनीति क्यों कर रहे हैं, हम क्यों देश को बार बार बांटना चाहते हैं, हम क्यों देश को गुमराह करना चाहते हैं. और इसलिए मैं माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी को बधाई देना चाहता हूं कि यह सरकार आने के बाद, इस सरकार आने के बाद जब हमने सबका साथ सबके विकास की बात करी तो हमने सबसे पहले देश के 115 पिछड़े जिलों को चुना जिनको हमने आकांक्षी जिला बनाया. उनको हमने पिछड़ा जिला नहीं कहा, उनको हमने एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट कहा. हमने कहा कि भारत अगर आगे बढ़ाए, हमारा यह क्षेत्र पीछे है तो आप भी आगे बढ़ो. और हमारे जो 115 आकांक्षी जिले बने, क्या वो भाजपा के शासन के बने, ऐसा नहीं है. उसमें आंध्र प्रदेश का अगर कड़प्पा जिला है उदाहरण के लिए, तो छत्तीसगढ़ का बस्तर जिला भी है. उसमें अगर हमारे मेघालय और मिजोरम के जिले हैं तो हरियाणा का नूह जैसा पूरा माइनॉरिटी वाले जिले को भी चुना गया है. उसमें आपको तो खुशी होगी कि केरल के वायनाड जिले को भी हम विकसित कर रहे हैं ताकि भविष्य में वो प्रिंसली स्टेट ना रह जाए. हमने तो अभी तक अमेठी जो था उसमें भी हम अब फैक्ट्री लेकर के आ गए हैं ताकि वो भी लोकतंत्र की अनुभूति के साथ विकास के रास्ते पे आगे बढ़े. और इसलिए हमने सारे जिलों को चुना है. हमने यहाँ पर वेस्ट बंगाल के लोग बैठे हैं, वेस्ट बंगाल में नदिया जिला है, दक्षिण दिनाजपुर है. तो ये क्यों चुने गए हैं, ये किसका संकल्प है, ये इस पूरे सदन का संकल्प होना चाहिए कि जो हमारे 115 जिले रह गए हैं वहां पर महिलाओं का स्वास्थ्य, वहां पर शिक्षा.
Alright, this is the discussion here which is on the BJP giving 0-hour notice in Rajya Sabha with respect to the CAA and the protests that have continued across the country against it. This was the BJP MP Bhupinder Yadav speaking on the issue, essentially countering the opposition's allegation against the CAA. Let's switch back to the focus here on the biggest concern for the coronavirus that has come in from the state of Kerala, because Kerala being the only standalone case which has three cases of confirmed case of coronavirus. State government, because of this, has now declared it a state disaster. As of now, 2,239 people are under observation in Kerala. Of these, 84 people are hospitalized, 2,155 are under home quarantine. Kerala tourism that has taken a hit following this outbreak. Several bookings at the hotels have now been cancelled.
Kerala today declared the end coronavirus issue as a state calamity because we want to strengthen our surveillance system and all the precautionary measures. Here, the first day itself when we came to know that end coronavirus is rampant in China, at the same time, we formed our RRT and other system here to contain this coronavirus. We expect that so many children are there in China from Kerala. We expect that they will come back and the coronavirus may affect in Kerala. At the same time, we started our surveillance system, contact tracing and the isolation, etc. The first day, one result became positive. And after that, yesterday and today, we have two more positive results.
Health Minister has made it very, very clear that the very reason why they have declared end coronavirus as a state calamity is because they want to make sure that all precautionary measures have been taken and no stones are unturned to make sure that this outbreak does not spread and there is no casualty that's been reported in this. Remember, 3 cases in India that's been tested positive. All the 3 are from Kerala, from Thrissur, Alappuzha, and the latest from Kasaragod. All the 3 have been under strict observation by the health officials. Senior doctors are looking at them. What we understand is that, all the 3 are, very stable, and they are, out of danger. They are, having conversation. They are, replying to the questions that's been asked. What we understand from this, when I spoke to the health department officials, is that, around 150 students from the Wuhan University and, other area near Wuhan province was supposed to come, to India in the month of December. Many people came, actually nearly 110 people actually managed to come. Some people actually got stuck up over there because some of these students in the Wuhan Medical University has to do their internship. And for that, the authorities have clearly informed them that for them to do the internship, they have to stay in Wuhan University itself. And that's the reason why, most of these medical students got stuck up over there. And, if most of these students were present there, the numbers would have gone still higher. But in this particular case, what we understood is this, that on 24th of January, from Kolkata to Delhi, from Kolkata to Nedumbasheri, around a number of students actually traveled, and all the 3 students who have been tested positive was traveling in the same flight. Also understand that these students had associated with at least 80 people while they were coming from China to Kerala, and all these 80 people have been thoroughly been checked.
In fact, the coronavirus outbreak has been discussed in the Rajya Sabha today as well. CPI leader Binoy Biswam said that now the centre should send in their team to Kerala.
State of Kerala has been forced to declare a disaster in 3 districts reported by coronavirus. And many people, around more than 2,000 people, are now under investigation. So this is a very serious issue. So take this issue as a national issue. I request the government of India to see that all the states, mainly just like Kerala, where the virus has been hit very badly, to send the team to the concerned states and render support by all means. I request the center to suddenly and urgently intervene. Thank you, sir.
The biggest concern today being, of course, in the state of Kerala regarding the coronavirus. With that, it is a wrap on the big story today. Thanks for being with us.